Good morning, children. Welcome back. Today also, we will continue with the direct and the indirect speech. Okay. So in the previous class, I taught you about some common rules to follow while changing the direct speech into the indirect. Okay. So today, the first rule was the adverbs of nearness should be put to the distance, like now becomes then, isn't it? Yesterday becomes the previous day, isn't it? Tomorrow becomes the next day or the following day, isn't it? Likewise, only I gave you many examples that day. Don't worry, I'm going to send you the PDF file also as well for that. And the second rule was if the reporting verb is in the present or in the future, then the reporting speech should not be changed. Okay, it should not be changed to past. I gave you an example like Aksha says I eat a mango, isn't it? Aksha says I eat a mango. Aksha says, it's in the present tense, isn't it? The reported verb. And if you see the second part of the sentence, I eat a mango, isn't it? The reporting speech, that is also in the present. So you'll have to see the first part, that is the reporting verb. So you'll have to write, Aksha says that she eats a mango. You can't write, Aksha said that she ate a mango. Okay, because the reporting verb is in the present. Or if it's in the future, then it will have to remain the same. Okay, that was rule number two. And then I gave you how to change simple present tense in the direct, how to change the simple present tense in the direct speech. If you'll have to change it into indirect, you'll have to change it to the past tense, like Janvi said, reporting verb, it's in the past. But if you see the second part of the sentence, that is I write a letter, that is in the present tense, isn't it? Janvi said, the reporting verb, okay, that's in the past. And if you see the second part of the sentence, that is in the present. So in the indirect speech, it will be in the simple past tense, like Janvi said that she wrote a letter. Okay, and and likewise, only for past tense in the indirect speech becomes past perfect, that I've already done. Present continuous in the direct becomes past continuous, and present perfect in the direct becomes past perfect, and present perfect continuous in the direct becomes past perfect continuous. I did all these in the previous class, and I told you about the exception that only for universal truth the tense of the direct speech remains unchanged. Like I gave you an example, the teacher said the sun rises in the east. If you see the first part of the sentence, the reporting verb, it is in the past. But if you see the second part of the sentence, the sun rises in the east, that is in the present. So you all can't write, because it's a universal truth that's happening day by day, isn't it? And it's going to happen till eternity. So for such truths, for such universal truth, even if the reported verb is in the reporting verb is in the past, the reported speech has to be in the present tense. Like the teacher said that the sun rises in the east. You can't write, the teacher said that the sun rose in the east. Okay, so you'll have to write, the teacher said that the sun rises in the east. Okay, and rule number three was regarding the pronouns. In order not to change the meaning of the sentence, you'll have to change the pronouns. Okay, now I'll tell you about the rules for imperative sentences. Okay, now see, rules for imperative sentences. okay, indirect speech for imperative sentences. So what exactly is an imperative sentence? You'll have to understand that first. So what is an imperative sentence? A sentence that expresses a command, a request, an order, an advice, or a suggestion, that is known as, that these are known as imperative sentences, isn't it? So these are the examples. See the sentence examples. Open the door. It's a command, isn't it? That you're asking someone to open the, you're ordering someone to open the door. You're commanding someone. That's a command. Please help me. That's a request. You're requesting someone. And quit smoking. That's an advice. So these are few examples of imperative sentences. So now, how to change the how to change the direct speech that's the imperative sentence into indirect speech. Okay, so I'm going to teach you that. Now usually you'll have to use words like requested, ordered, advised, forbade, suggested, if you'll have to change the direct speech into the indirect. Okay, I'm going to give you few sentence example. So look at the board. These are the examples of all the imperative sentences. Okay, now see this sentence example, okay? So you'll have to use specific words like requested, ordered, advised, suggested, etc. Okay, now see the first example in the direct sentence examples, okay? Sentence examples. Now see, said to me, please help me. Okay, this is in the direct. Please help me. Okay, this is in the direct. This is the direct speech. So if you'll have to change it into indirect, you'll have to write see requested. Okay, you'll have to use words, specific words like requested, advised, suggested. Okay, so see requested. Me to help her. Okay. So this is the rule. This is how you are supposed to change the direct speech into the indirect speech. So I'm going to read out a few examples for you. Teacher said to him, don't waste your time. That's in the direct. So if he'll have to change it into indirect, he'll have to write, teacher advised him not to waste his time. Advised. Teacher advised, isn't it? Now, doctor said to him, avoid unhealthy food. That's in the direct. So if you'll have to change it into indirect, you'll have to write, doctor advised him to avoid unhealthy food. Okay, now come to the next one. He said to his servant, clean the room. So that's a command or an order, isn't it? So he ordered his servant to clean the room. Okay, this is how you're supposed to change the direct speech into the indirect. Rules for change indirect speeches for imperative sentences. Okay, now come to the next one, that is rules for interrogative sentences. Okay, rules for interrogative. Now children, what's an interrogative sentence? Rules for interrogative sentences. Imperative sentence. Indirect speech for interrogative sentences. So what are interrogative sentences, children? Interrogative sentences are question sentences, isn't it? When you ask a question, isn't it? That's an interrogative sentence, okay? So there are two main kinds of interrogative sentences. The ones which start with an auxiliary verb and the other which start with a question word. One starting, there are two types of interrogative sentences. One starts with an auxiliary verb and the other starts with question words like what, why, when, how, etc. And auxiliary verbs means the helping verbs like she said to me, are you coming with us? Are you coming with us? Okay, so auxiliary verbs, the auxiliary verbs like were, will, is, are, these are known as interrogative sentences starting with auxiliary verbs. Okay. So, interrogative sentences beginning with an auxiliary verbs are changed into indirect speech using the connective if or whether. So, if the sentences in the direct speech are starting off with are, were, will, then in the indirect speech, you'll have to use words like if or whether. Okay, so in the indirect speech, you'll have to use words like what, if or whether. Okay, the reporting verb said or any other words used as the reporting verb changes to asked, queried, questioned, demanded of, or inquired of in the indirect speech. So you'll have to use specific words like inquired, questioned, demanded. Okay, when the reporting verb has an object. Okay, like for example, I'm going to cite few examples for you. She said to me, now look at this sentence, okay children. Sentence examples. Sentence example. She said to him. She said to him. You have an object over here, isn't it? Him is the object. So, she said to him, are you? It's starting off with an auxiliary verb, are, isn't it? So, if the direct speech is starting off with auxiliary verbs like will, were, are, then you'll, in the indirect speech, you'll have to use words like if or whether. Are you? Are you coming with us? Are you coming? Are you coming? Are you coming with us? Okay. With us. Okay, so if you'll have to change this one into indirect, you'll have to use words like if or whether. So how you are going to change it into indirect? Look at the board. See. Asked, you can use words like inquired, asked, demanded, etc. She asked me if. Did you see if over here? Because it has an object over here. Okay, if I was coming or going, I was going with them. Us becomes them, the rule pronoun, okay, them. So she asked me if I was going with them. I'm going to read out few examples for you. She said to him, am I to wait for you till eternity? She inquired of him if she was to wait for him till eternity. The next one is, don't you know the way home? I said to her, I asked her whether she did not know the way home. Okay, The next one is, what do you want? Now question words, isn't it? What do you want? She asked him. So in such questions, in the direct speech, you're not supposed to use if or whether. Like for example, what do you want? She asked me. She asked him, okay? She asked him what he wanted. Come to the next one. Which way should I go? Asked the little girl. The little girl asked which way she should go. Over here, in such sentences, in the direct speech, which are starting with words like which, what, in such questions or in such direct speeches, if you'll have to change it into indirect, you're not supposed to use if or whether. Only in the auxiliary verb starting off with are, were, will, you're supposed to use if or whether. Okay, now rules for exclamatory sentences. Okay. Rules for exclamatory sentences. Rules for exclamators and indirect speeches. Speech for, sorry, exclamatory sentence. Exclamatory sentences, okay? So what is an exclamatory sentence? A sentence that expresses a state of sorrow, joy, or wonder is known as an exclamatory sentence. Examples for exclamatory sentences, okay? Hurrah, and an exclamation mark, isn't it? I won the match, okay? This is an exclamatory sentence. It is expressing the state of joy that the person is very, very happy that he has won the match, isn't it? So words like hurrah, alas, wow are used in all the exclamatory sentences, okay? And exclamatory sentence expresses the state of joy, sorrow, or wonder. To change them into indirect speech, specific words like exclaimed with wonder, exclaimed with sorrow, okay, are added to the sentence. If you'll have to change such sentences into indirect, you'll have to use words like exclaimed with wonder, exclaimed with joy, exclaimed with sorrow, etc. Okay, now come to the first example. They said, hurrah. Hurrah, we won the match. This is in the direct, isn't it? This is in the direct speech. So if you'll have to change it into indirect, you'll have to use words like they exclaimed with joy. They had won the match, okay? So see children, you'll have to use words in such sentences which expresses the state of joy over here, isn't it? They said, hurrah, we won the match. match. That's in the direct. So if you'll have to change it into indirect speech, you'll have to use words like exclaimed with joy, exclaimed with wonder, exclaimed with sorrow. So we are few examples. I'm going to read it out to you. He said, "Alas, I failed the test." He exclaimed with sorrow that he failed the test. He said, "Oh, I lost my wallet." He exclaimed with sorrow that he had lost his wallet. Okay, these are all for direct and indirect speech. Okay, I'm going to send you the PDF file also as well. If you have any problems, then please let me know. Okay, thank you.